Now, we talked about last week about living faith. Living faith. Nothing dead can receive life.
Amen.
Nothing dead can receive life. So we talked about that. We talked about how your faith is a muscle and how you need to develop your faith. You never want to never use your faith and then one day try to fight cancer. Right. You don't want to do that.
Amen.
Start building your faith. Start reaching to do things that you need your faith for. For instance, now, they used to tell us this to do it with materialism. You know, believe God for a car that you can't afford. No, this isn't true. Believe God for a house you can't afford. And then when God gave you a house, that's how you exercise your faith. Keep getting more and more and more. But try using your faith for character adjustment.
Mm. Amen.
People that you know you just can't stand. Now, some of y'all deep and act like you ain't got nobody like that. Try using your faith that I can forgive people that lied on me and I ain't did nothing to them. It's nothing worse than having somebody lie on you and you sitting back just as baffled. Can't you understand why?
Yes, mm-hmm.
So true. My wife and I seem to constantly be victims of this. I'm telling you, man, I don't know what it is. We got one man, we started we had a meeting, and in the meeting, we invited people to the meeting because we was going out. You know, I have a trucking business. And what we was doing was we wanted to have something all black and successful, right? Now, I didn't mean no to offend him. I didn't mean to hurt his feelings. But I told everybody my intentions. Well, he was married to a white woman, and he wanted to bring his wife to the meeting. And I said, no, you can't bring her. Now, I know some of y'all say, that sounds racist. It wasn't racist. I just wanted my people to have something that we can build and make it great.
Right.
Now, I don't know nothing about science. I don't know nothing about athleticism as far as me implementing skill on a court or field, but I did know trucking.
Right.
And he got so mad, he went back telling people, this was about a year later or whatever, he went back telling people, yeah, his business was going under, and he got mad because I wouldn't help him save his business. Now, my wife and I, not only did we have a proposal to these people, then we did this top notch. Not only did we have a proposal, but we also had our bank records. So we told the people, we don't need you, but together we can do something bigger. And boy, I'm telling you, he just went on, just lying. He started lying, and then somebody else started lying.
Right.
One of the guys said, this is the truth. He lying about how my business failed, and I needed help. It prompted another guy to start lying that say he knew me from Brooklyn. And then this guy don't know me from Brooklyn. But when you start getting around lies, you start lying.
Amen. Amen.
So you always gonna have somebody that is going to come at you wrong. Get faith to forgive them without them even asking.
Amen.
They don't ask for forgiveness. Who you are in God is going to make this relationship whole. And you ain't got to come to me and tell me what you did. You ain't got to explain what you did. I'm going to forgive you anyway. Do you understand? Can I believe in God for that? Start trying to use God to build character instead of trying to use God to get stuff.
Amen. Right.
That's true. All right. So we start talking about your faith requires action. Anytime you believe in God for something, get your ears ready to hear God. If you don't hear God, you don't know what to do. This is why most people are lost to the voice of God. If the only voice you got from God is me, you're going to be stagnant. You're not going to grow like you should. There must be a personal relationship between you and God.
Right.
Now, I'm going to have a word because I'm going to spend time with God. He's going to tell me what to say. Now, let me tell you something. So 2 weeks ago, God gave me what to talk about this living faith. This week, I was studying, and it had nothing to do with the sermon. So I was sitting there saying, I really, subconsciously, I'm just going out there trying to help God out, not even conscious of what I'm saying. And I said, it seems like I should be studying what I'm going to be preaching. And God said, you don't need to study what you're going to preach. You just need to say what I tell you.
Right.
Because I was studying this week, they said, in the name of Jesus. That's how you get stuff done in the earth. Well, I need to know what that really means.
Mm-hmm.
And then you have to start with what qualifies me to represent Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
Because to say in the name of Jesus is to say I'm an ambassador.
Right.
I am in Jesus' stead.
Right.
Then I went into so many other things about the power of his name. You know, I'm just studying this all week long. Never study. See, now, this is what you got to understand. Once you hear God, and you got that thing on the right track, you ain't got to worry about anything else that's going on. Come on another track.
Right.
Hearing God is essential if you're going to have faith in anything.
Amen.
My success in life is founded upon God speaking and me obeying.
Amen.
God will change you. Right now, you can think success is the car you drive. Hang around God long enough, that car means nothing to you.
Amen.
I'm telling you.
Amen.
There's a freedom and a liberation for you not to be concerned about what other people think concerning you, what you drive, where you live, and what you wear. That's a trick of the enemy to keep you broke. It's for you to try to wear what you can't afford. But because you know you're going to get people's attention, I'm willing to make the sacrifice of my future so I can look good for the moment. You ain't even got to say amen to that. I know I'm telling the truth. 90% of people have absolutely nothing in their life they had to give 150% to accomplish. Over and beyond. Man, I've been running that thing by my kids. I asked my oldest daughter. She said, yeah, it was a class. She had to give 150% to pass. But you ask the average adult, this is the truth. Now, I'm not trying to hurt your feelings because there ain't nobody here like that.
Amen.
You know that. That was a good point to boost your own. You know, poor frog to worship his own pond. That was a good spot for you to say, yeah. Listen, 90%, you need to look over your life and see, what have I ever accomplished that I had to go beyond average to make it happen? I don't care if it was a diet. I don't care if it was a body spa. You wanted. What did you ever have to do to go over and beyond? See, when you start getting the character of going over and beyond, it might start in your diet, but it ain't gonna stop there.
Right.
Every winner, do you hear me? You better hear me on this. Every winner got something right now on their plate. I got to go over and beyond to make it happen. If you ain't got nothing on your plate, I question whether or not you are a real winner. Now you can say, don't try to offend me, don't come at me, and all this other stuff. You need something that you're pushing toward that I got to give over and beyond.
Yeah.
If it's a house, I ain't eating out no more until I eat in my kitchen.
Come on.
Can I tell you something? You want to know why fast food restaurants are as prosperous as they are? Is because of the laziness of people. No. Some of y'all is busy, but you got some laziness mixed up in there.
Amen.
No. Whatever day you're off, you can cook. You can cook enough.
Come on.
Yes, sir. See. Let me tell you. Let me tell you how I live. I bought my first house when I was 19 years old. Now that wasn't because God sent money in the mailbox. You know, just supernaturally. I worked 3 jobs. And my mama taught me how to save. And what were my 3 jobs? I used to wake up and I would go to ASCE, American Society of Civil Engineers. And that was on 47 and 1st, right across from the UN building. I would leave there at about 3, this is God's honor, would leave there about 3:30, 3:45, and I have to be at Gristini's, which was a supermarket. I had to be there by 4 o'clock. Gristini's was on 63rd. And 2nd, right across the street from Trump, I don't know if it's Trump Towers now. So I would run. I would see, y'all don't know about going from 47th to 63rd. Mm-hmm. I know it don't sound like a lot when you just do the math of it. Try running it. Now, my boss name was Mr. Lake, and I knew his schedule, and then the assistant manager was John Sedina. And when John was working, I could be a little late. When Mr. Lake was working, I couldn't be late. You had to be suited up to clock in. Now, you couldn't run in with your jacket. See, I know y'all ain't used to that kind of discipline. You couldn't run in with your jacket and your hat and clock in. You had to have your I was in the deli. I had to have my deli jacket on and my deli jacket hat to clock in. You understand? You ready for work now. You ain't ready for work with your jacket on. I used to run, and then after Gristini's, I would get off around 9 o'clock, 9:30. I would go and clean the barbershop. Now, I did this for about 2 years. And I began to save my money, save my money, save my money, save my money, until I had enough money to get my house. And then what happened was, we wound up, we met this girl, and we decided we was gonna get married. And so, you know, the voodoo was working on me. So, but then we wanted to go buy this house. Now to go buy the house, we had to go pay off her student loans because we, to qualify for the house, we gonna get the house together. So the little money I had saved, I had to pay off her student loans. Then I went to go get a ring I couldn't afford. But that diamond was sitting up there saying, yeah, this is going to catch people's eyes.
Right, right, right.
And now, mind you, we already in the mix now of buying the house. When we went to closing, we was about $2,000 short. My mother gave me the money for me to get this house when I'm 19. But see, this is what you got to understand. If I had not made those sacrifices,
right.
Now you look, now what you got to understand, there was nothing that I was going overboard for. Now I'm not telling you to do this, and I'm not trying to gloat in what I'm saying. But where I was going, I didn't care whether people would applaud me.
Amen.
I knew I had to go over and beyond.
Come on.
So even after I got my house, when I go to work, I didn't have no problem bringing the leftovers from last night for lunch tomorrow.
Amen. Amen.
When I had my trucking company, I had employees that had to stop by Wawa every morning to get their breakfast, their drinks. Now, I already had mine in the cooler.
Right.
I used to get a case of water and just, you know, you got to pour a little bit out of all of them so you can get a good shake on that, the powder. And I make about 5 or 6 bottles for the week now.
Right.
5 or 6 bottles of stuff to drink, and I'm mixing them up, put them in the refrigerator. Now, I'm just going to grab them and go. That's something if you want to accomplish. Gonna require you to go over and beyond.
Right.
Now, is it in you to do it?
Come on.
Here's the thing. I'm gonna give you an idea. Every one of y'all to do it, but studies say out of 10 people, you might get one. Well, it's really less than one, because that would be 10%. So, let's go with 100. If it was 100 people listening to me and they go do this, right, if I tell them this, that we would have about what is less than 10, about 7%, would be 70 off 100.
Mm-hmm.
You may have 6 to 7 people that might do it. What is it? Let me show you a way to make some quick money. You interested?
Yes.
Yeah. Everybody won't.
Mm-hmm.
But we'll find out whether you're willing to go get it.
Okay.
You can go right now and go to yard sales, estate sales, buy stuff, and sell it online.
Mm-hmm.
Yard sales and estate sales are usually drastically cheaper than what's on eBay.
Right.
Yeah, you say, well, no. You got to come up with another plan. Like, is it something I can do from my phone? Find out where the estate sale is.
Right. Come on. Keep going.
Yeah.
Are you listening?
Yeah.
So you go to the yard sale. It's not about what I need or what I want. What can I sell?
Right.
Yeah.
So you look around, you seeing some dishes, you seeing whatever you, man, I don't care what it is. If you know you can sell it, then I need to buy it.
Right.
Because in the yard sale, they're going to be talking about something, yeah, you can have it all for $5.
Mm-hmm.
Now, don't try to pay your house off with a $5 purchase at the yard sale.
Right. Right.
No, because if you price it right, I'm going to tell you a real business move, all right? If I spent $5 to get that mic stand, I got $5 for what I spent. I'm going to charge you for my gas and the use of my car.
Mm-hmm.
No, this business now.
Mm-hmm.
All right? And I'm going to make sure my time, I'm getting a little something. Now, when I sell that, because I ain't driving five days to know yard sale. Usually, I ain't going nowhere no more than a gallon of gas.
Mm-hmm.
And if I pay myself $3, for my time. So now I got to sell this thing for $12. When I sell it for $12, that $5 is my capital.
Right.
Y'all do know what the capital is.
Yes.
The $5 is my capital. I can't spend it.
Mm-hmm.
That's for another rock.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
Come on now.
Come on.
When I buy another rock, I'm going to sell it again.
Mm-hmm.
Now the reason I'm not going to get greedy with my profit, because I want to make money off the quality. Because the lower my price, the faster it'll sell.
Right.
And I'm ready for my next project.
Right.
Now, not only am I going to keep the $5 for my capital, I'm teaching you some business.
Amen.
That's right. Come on.
Not only am I going to keep the $5 of my capital, I'm going to take $1 of my profit and add it to my cap.
Okay.
So the next time I go to the yard sale, I'm looking something for
$6.
Right.
The $6 product can sell for $15.
Mm-hmm.
When I sell that product, I'm going to add $1 to my cap.
Amen.
Are y'all hearing me?
Yes.
Listen, if you go into some sites, eBay and some others, you might get more than what you're asking for.
Mm-hmm.
My wife and I, we have a tenant right now that came straight from heaven. No lie.
Mm-hmm.
She'd been living in this house of ours for years. We was renting that house for $1,300 a month. We had the house out, and all of a sudden, two people came to rent that house. One person came to rent the house. He said, I'll take it. So I called the realtor. Realtor called me and said, we got such and such, said they'll take it. I said, good, let's move forward. And then he called back about 3 hours later. He said, wait a minute. There's somebody else called and said they want it, and they'll pay you $1,350. I said, well, you know, I mean, is it, you know, one got bad credit? No. This is about the same, either way you go. I said, well, go with the $1,350.
Hmm.
He said, all right, then we're good. I'll set it up. I'll let the other people know that we got somebody else. Good. The next morning, so he called me back. He said, the other people said they'll pay you
$1,400.
Hmm. But then go back with the $1,400. Tell them, other people, we sorry.
Right.
Later on that day, he said, the other people said they'll pay you $1,500.
Whoa.
What? What? That ain't nothing to talk about.
Right.
You don't need to be calling me.
Right.
Don't waste your time, sir. Get that deposit. So he went to the other people and told them they were willing to pay $1,500. The other people came back and said, I'll pay you $1,550. She's been paying me $1,550 for over, what, 6, 7 years now?
Hmm.
See, let me tell you something. When God wants to increase you, you got to have a plan in place.
Yes.
Are y'all listening to me?
Yes.
So what is in your life you're willing to go out on Saturday morning? Because if you want to catch the yard sale, you know you got to get up early.
That's right.
You come in at 10:30, 11 o'clock in the morning.
That's right.
So I go to the yard sale, I'm going to find something, then I'm going to sell it, and I'm going to make it. It's similar to stocks. You hear me?
Yes.
If I can catch something on sale, I need to think, can I resell it?
Mm.
See, here's the thing. God said, I give you the power to get wealth. He never said, I'll give you wealth.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So now what you need to do is, what do I have to get the money from somebody else's pocket?
Right.
Come on.
Do you hear me?
Amen.
Now I got a truck. Now God, now hear what I'm saying. All glory go to God.
Amen.
God don't give me money. He gave me a truck.
Mm-hmm.
Now however I got the truck, you know, it all trickles back to God, but I got the truck. When the phone ring, I got to be ready to move. This guy called me one time. Now, I'm not telling you to do this. Don't. You can call me cocky. You can call me whatever you want. But I already know what God did for me. Guy called me one time. It must have been about 1:30, 2 o'clock in the morning. He said, I got a truck that broke down. I wanted to know, could you go and pick up that load and get it over to the you know, whatever destination it had to go to? I said, well, you know, how much are you paying? And then one time he called. He said, I can get you $150. I just hung up the phone. Now, I don't even put my key in the ignition for $150. That ain't gonna happen. Another time he called and said $175. Another time he called $200. Then finally I just told him, listen to me. Anytime you call me after midnight, you got to be at $500. Easy.
Right.
Now you may say, oh, you're getting a little cocky.
No.
But my bills are still paid though.
Yeah.
You can't call me for what I got and can't pay me what I want.
Right.
Now, I ain't getting out of my bed for $150. You crazy?
Right.
What is wrong with you? Man, I can't even sell that to my wife.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I'm going to go make this $150 at 12:30.
Right.
You know, some of these women ain't wrapped too tight.
Yes, right.
They start talking about something. Ain't nothing open after 10.
That's
but
right.
But hospital and legs. Now, are you going to the hospital?
Right.
I am feeling a little congested. No, listen to me. When God bless you, you got to know what I'm doing with what he gave me.
Amen.
The talent God gives you, you got to make that work. So now there's no reason for you not to be increasing every week.
Amen.
Are you listening?
Amen.
See, now you know why most of you won't do it? Because it ain't easy enough. I need something easier. I need something that I can do that people will just hand me the money. People will just give me the money. I thought you was going to tell me to turn around 3 times.
They ain't going to do nothing for you.
I mean, unless you lift the knees a little bit, you might burn a couple calories. But for the most part, you ain't getting nothing.
Right.
You're going to have to go over and beyond. If you're going to grow in God, you got to be willing to work. Do what God tells you to do. See, that's why the devil don't want you to get the word of God. See, once you get the word of God, it translates to the character of God. And the character of God will give you his voice. See, you can't have your mind over in la-la land and think you're going to hear God. It's when you become, it becomes an inward work. You start hearing how God wants me to live, and I start pushing myself in that direction. And the more I move in that direction, the more I can hear God.
Amen.
Now, you can't make one step toward God and all of a sudden you're hearing how to go from Section 8 all the way up to the penthouse in Manhattan. It don't work like that.
Amen.
You got to hear God to grow.
Right.
You don't hear God to impress.
Right. That's true.
Come on, y'all got to catch that. You got to catch that.
Right.
You hear God to grow, not to impress.
Yes.
Amen.
You hear God so that you can be a blessing to someone else.
Amen.
I don't pray for materialism for myself, but I pray for it for you.
Amen.
Amen.
I don't pray for cars. I don't pray for houses. I don't pray for none of that stuff. I don't pray for money. I don't do none of that. I just trust God. But when I pray for you, I do. You need to be in the same position. God, I ain't coming to you for no how. I'm telling about the roof leading. I ain't coming to you for that.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
When I come to pray for me and God, it's all about me acting like God.
Yes. Jesus.
So now you got to get to the place I'm willing to put the work in. If your faith don't have action to support it, you don't have faith. You just a wishful thinker.
Yeah.
You saw something and you want it, but you're not willing to do what needs to be done to get it.
Amen.
You know, I'm going to tell you this. I may not get too many amens, but it's all right. I am not for any government that is going to just keep giving people money that have made it clear in their mind, I don't want to be nothing.
Right.
I don't want to be nothing. I want to sit at home, hump all day, eat all day, and I don't want no job. I ain't looking for no job. I want you to keep saying, I'm not for that garbage.
Right.
Especially when we got veterans, people that are willing to put their life on the line to keep us safe.
Mm.
Those people ain't got what they need.
Right.
Come on now. Right.
No, I'm not for that. Now, you may not like what I'm saying, but I don't care. Listen, we need, if somebody's going to help you, they need to give you an opportunity, not money.
Right, that's true.
If they give you money, that money got to lead to opportunity.
Right,
yeah.
Amen.
Listen, it don't take nobody, you know, Giuliani, before he became crazy, he was the mayor of New York. He's the one that got me locked up on the gun charge. Because when he came into office, he said, if you get caught with a gun, the minimum is 12 months in jail. And 12 to 36 months in jail. That's absolute minimum. All right? And but he had a plan. He said, we ain't got to hire no more city workers. He said, everybody that's getting city money at home got to come out and clean the streets. Oh, boy, people went crazy. I never understood these. I'm talking about politicians. I don't understand why is it a bad thing that if I'm giving you money, you got to earn it. You're going to embarrass the people you go. They're not embarrassed to go cash it.
Right.
They ain't embarrassed to go to that ATM.
Right.
Boy, I'm telling you, that was a good plan. That was a good plan. I never got free money.
Right.
No. Had to work for mine.
Yes.
Yeah. I know some of y'all getting mad. Come talk about your mama, your auntie, your sister. I don't care. You got to get to the place that I understand that if people are not willing to work for what they say they want,
right,
they don't really want it. Everybody's about getting on a government program so that they can take care of their kids. It's not the government job. Now, I want the kids taken care of. I don't want them to be a loser because they might. But that kid need to be in an environment,
right,
at school that let them know there's a better way.
That's right.
No, give them all the medical attention they need. Make sure they got plenty to eat. I'm all for that for the kids.
Uh-huh.
put that tax money toward WIC or whatever else they call it for the kids. But their mama?
Right.
No, she need a job.
That's right.
She need a job. He said, well, I got to have a babysitter. We're going to find you a job where you can do like the Africans. You're going to strap that baby on your back.
Yeah.
And you going to work. I understand you make babysitting somebody else's responsibility.
Right.
Let me leave that alone. I don't want to take my glasses off, so y'all roll your eyes. Mm-hmm. You say one more thing about my mama. See when I come out there. So God living in you is always proven. When God starts wanting to increase you, I can see it in your actions. You're doing more. I'm not motivated by the money, but I'm motivated with a better life. Money comes along with it.
Yes.
No doctor goes to college, goes to medical school, makes $200,000 a year, and he said, oh, I never knew. Right. He's not surprised.
Right, right.
Ain't no brain surgeon up just, what? You gonna pay me $250,000? He's not surprised.
Right.
When that man go to medical school and learn how to make people with big noses have small noses, people with three chins have one.
Right.
Come on. Man, that man ain't surprised. He's making $5 or $6 million a year.
Yes.
When somebody come out, their butt is flat as this board. They come out, child, their butt is round as the moon. Boy, he expecting $10 million a year.
Right, right.
All your fat butt women won't be. Yeah. So when you put the work in, you're not surprised.
Right, right.
When the money show up.
That's true.
Stop being average.
Amen.
You believe God. You got to live in faith. You ought to be working on it.
Right.
Yes.
Sitting around, I believe God. Believe God for what? You know, just cliches and declarations ain't enough. Try going out when everybody here they got a car. Don't touch it. Just keep decreeing. Start. You can start right now. Just decree and declare it's gonna start and take you home. Just oh, you gonna start in Jesus' name? How bad you say? You a liar and ain't no truth in it. Shama. And you can't stay in the church. Church got to be locked up. I'm telling you that right now.
Right.
You have to sit out there. Hope you got a hat and coat.
Right.
You can't talk no car to start. You can't talk no car to drive safe. You need to learn how to drive.
Right.
Because I never drove before, but I believe God. What?
Right.
You never drove before, but you believe God.
Yeah.
You never had $100,000 before, but you believe God. Guess what you're going to do with that $100,000? The same thing you're going to do with that car. You got to get to the place I'm willing to put the work in. When I hear from God, it's proven in what I do. You're going to have a good life, but it's going to be proven in what you're doing. It's not about how much you're making. It's about what you're doing with what you make.
Come on now. Come on.
You know, they used to have this show years ago. I don't know if they still have it, where they would take somebody and they would give them $100,000, and they couldn't work. They had to work off that $100,000. Most of the people was broke within a year. Because if you don't learn what you are doing, that's wrong. Now, where you at is because of your decisions. Where you at is because of your intellect. I'm not trying to hurt your feelings. So if I give you $100,000, guess where you're going to be a year from now? Right where you at right now. When you want to grow but not willing to get the knowledge, you're not going far.
Right.
I need you to grow. I need you to be hungry for knowledge. Some of us ain't going back to school. Notice I said us. I'm not going back to college. But our kids are in college, and they're not in college because the class they're taking is what they think gonna call their life the boom.
Right.
That class they're taking is gonna make them disciplined, focused, teach them how to get something done. See, it's different when you're young and you're going to school.
Right.
You almost, I don't know if you got new parents these days, you know. I don't know you're going to get your butt whipped if you don't do it. You're going to lose some privileges if you don't go to school and do what's right. But now you get to the place, every child needs to experience a college campus life.
True.
It's going to show you what you've been putting in your kids. They're in high school, they're getting all B's and A's. They go to college, they're getting D's and C's. Now this semester, I'm telling you right now, they'll be in the F category. They'll be sending them home soon. Some schools that's worth anything ain't gonna let you hang out there, and you ain't got no decent grade. You make us look bad.
That's right.
Because we know we're giving you what's required.
Right. That's true.
You know, they used to say, well, you know, in college, they don't care, because yes, they do.
Right.
The ones that got a name, all right? You need to start implementing something, hearing young people that say, I'm still focused, I'm still disciplined. You got to overcome some stuff to make it through college on the college campus. Some people say college, I talk to people. Some people, I remember years ago, this was right around, I think it was Bill Clinton or one of the presidents, you know, talking about they smoke weed in college. Did you know they were talking about, I forget the percentage, it was a high percentage of people smoked the first time they smoked weed was in college. Mm-hmm. In college. So if you're going to be something, you got to walk through them roads. Mm-hmm. All the influences. They say on college, boy, they party on Tuesday like it's Friday.
Yes.
Chad, you be talking about something. I know my baby ain't nothing much for them to do.
Mm-hmm.
So I know they just probably bored, reading them books. Child, your child, some on somebody table. Listen to me. Success don't come because you want it. Success don't come because you tired of being broke. You got to have actions to support where you going.
Jesus.
What are you reading? Who is your mentor?
Come on, Pastor.
Who's teaching you? You're not going to have a better life without a teacher. Success is designed. For people that want to learn and implement what they learn will have a better life. If you took all the money in the world and gave it to the poor people, every 30 days, you're going to see a large transformation from the poor to the rich. It's not money that make rich people rich. It's the character of the people that make them rich. So what actions do you have? Listen to me. Depending on the school and the class will determine the fee and the tuition. There are some schools you can go to and you ain't got to spend $10,000 a year. $10,000 a semester, whatever they want to call it. There are some schools you're going to, honey, $10,000, that take care of the lunch. Now, we know when your child needs somewhere to sleep, we got to heat the room, cool the room. We got to pay the teacher. There are some schools, you know, this was years ago before, when we just first got married. We knew a man, his daughter was in Yale. He said every 6 months he had to send Yale $78,000. This is over 20 something. We didn't have no kids then. Bishop Billings was his name in Brooklyn. He said he had to send Yale $78,000 every 6 months. That's a lot of money. Well, let me tell you something. There's some things you're going to learn, and it's going to come with benefits.
That's true.
Now, I'm about to say something, and I'm not trying to tear nobody down. You can't come from Spelman and think you don't have an advantage over somebody that got the community college. Now, you're going to community college, you keep going. Don't be stupid now.
Right, right.
But you need to know, what county is this here? Camden County or Community College, if they got such a thing, you don't measure the same as somebody with a Harvard degree.
Right.
Right.
That's true.
But the fee is going to be drastically different.
Sure.
My good friend, his daughter went to Columbia, and Columbia said, hey, how you doing, sir? Such and such needs $30,000 by Monday. So Monday, we're going to see you for one way or another. Either you're here with a van to pick her up, or you're here to give us a check. That's before Cash App and all that. Yeah, it's going to cost you. Most of you are going to learn. Your tuition, your fees are going to be paid with tears, heartbreak, shame, embarrassment, but what have you learned from the hardship you've been through?
Right.
If you
My grandmother, the only one said, preach, Papa. They don't want to hear him, but preach.
Come on now.
Now, I'm about to say some stuff. It's for your betterment. It's not to offend you. When you had the first baby and couldn't keep the daddy around, what did you learn? So what did you learn? Because everything you go through, you paying a tuition with your heart, with your emotions, with your body, with your future, and you're not learning anything.
Right.
You know, there are many people that got diplomas and don't know much.
Right.
Public schools are known for getting kids out of there that should come on.
Right.
You know, this guy, he said there were two people. Well, I can't tell that joke. Ain't no way to clean that joke up. That joke ain't right. That was a lie. You got to get to the place that I'm not going to be the person that they push along just because I'm 21.
Right.
So, well, you know, he's 17 years old. We can't keep him in the sixth grade again. Have y'all had your little kids play football and your little child come out about 3 feet and he running out there just as cute, you got your little camera, then all of a sudden you see a wall out there. You say, who kid is that?
Right.
I say, yeah, he in the same, he ain't but seven. You say, I been down. That is
right.
He better not touch my baby, I know that much. Now you take your child home, you tell them to put them aside, say, listen here, let me tell you something right now. If you see that monster coming at you, throw the ball. He said, but mommy, I'm not the quarterback, you can get rid of the ball. No, you just know this ain't fair. Let me tell you something. You are not going to advance just because you've been in the class a long time. You gotta make different decisions. What was in me to make me attracted to this type of person?
Right.
What is in me to make me want to be in the company of people that keep getting me locked up?
Right.
How can somebody just go in and out of jail?
Right.
I mean, can you imagine walking in, your child come up, the judge know your child. They look at him and say, Clifford? Oh, Lord. What'd you do now, Clifford? No, I know you didn't do nothing.
Right.
No! If you don't, you know, I'm telling you what my son said this morning, not because it's my son, because it's true. If you don't know, the people in your life will affect your future. If you don't know that's true, you headed nowhere fast.
Come on now.
Amen. That's a fact.
That's right.
So I got to know why am I constantly in the same position.
Yeah.
With airways, the everybody broke, you need to change your company.
Right.
That's an easy fix.
Yeah.
You get paid on Friday. Don't touch your, don't pay nobody, don't touch your check till Monday.
Right.
If your checks are not touching, there's a problem somewhere.
Right.
No, I got more bills than I got money. I said the checks need to touch.
Right.
Amen.
Your checks need to touch.
Amen.
Which means maybe you need to get a flip phone that you only can text and call.
Right.
Don't come telling me your checks can't touch and you're trying to get an iPhone 12.
Right.
No. You need your next pair of sneakers. You need to buy you a good $20 pair of sneakers and a roll of duct tape. Because your checks need to touch. See, you how you going to set principles on going to the next level and you're a loser?
Right.
If you're going to win, I got to implement things winners do. Nobody caring about what people think about you putting tape around your shoes.
Right.
Don't nobody care nothing about. Listen to me. People are irrelevant when it comes to what you're willing to do to make things better for you and yours.
That's right.
What are you learning from the tuitions that you're paying? What are you going through and you're not learning anything from it? Go to Matthew 15 and 8. Oh, have mercy. Your grade is determined by the character you develop when you come out of the test. Don't come telling me nothing about who you are and there's no character adjustment.
Right.
I keep people at a distance until you qualify to get closer. See, if you're so lonely that you just need somebody in your life, there's a good chance you're gonna get the wolf into the hen house. Then you wanna know where my chickens at. And the wolf said, there's a, I said, I had three chickens at Jesus. The wolf was saying, I swear for God, I ain't seen not a chicken. There's somebody that can be contaminating your future.
Yes.
Cut them off. You don't even need to give them a response. You know, my biggest problem is letting people down easy. Now, I really don't want to hurt people's feelings sometimes. Unless you come wrong, you get checked wrong. I don't want to let people know you don't qualify to be in my life. Like, I won't do that. I won't just, I'm not scared of nobody. But I ain't going to be walking this in, man. Don't come to my house no more. No, I just don't want you around. You have things about you I don't like. I wouldn't say that. So I carefully distance myself. But if I'm in bed with you, now I'm not talking about physically, if we hanging out together, going out together, and I find out you out there robbing drug dealers, no, I'm just saying, bro, you can't come, no, because you ain't going to entangle me with that mess.
Right.
These jokers don't know how to shoot out here.
Right.
No, you can't come in. See, I will be gentle with pushing you away. As long as you ain't doing no damage in my life. Like, you talking to robbing drug dealers, they looking for you.
Right.
I don't need them to find you at my pool party.
Amen.
Right.
Amen.
No. I don't want them. Listen, talk about something. I'm gonna meet you at church. No, wait. Hold up just a minute, brother. Because you don't have to come into the building.
Right.
We are the church. There's no need for you to come. No, because you can cause damage to mess up my future.
Right.
Don't be nice to Don't be nice to your mama when you know she's contaminating your future.
Mom,
I love you, but we ain't about to talk about that.
Right.
We ain't about to talk about that. You ain't about to tell me nothing about my man. You ain't about to tell me nothing about my man, because the five I seen you with last year, you ain't gonna tell me nothing about that. Listen, I don't talk to people that's poorer than me about my money. I get people all day. I tell you, why do these people come from all of a sudden with this 4X or something, and Bitcoin and some other investment? Like, I'm sending up people, why are you befriending me? No, I mean, especially if I know you. It don't make no sense. I'm not trying to hurt you. You can call me Arab, you can call me what you want. But that's a rule I ain't going to break. Broke people can't talk to me about my money.
That's right.
Where can you take me but where you been?
Right.
Go ahead and get in the car if you want to and go to sleep. No, it requires trust for me to sleep.
Right.
Amen. I drive my wife sometimes, the spirit shake me. The spirit says, you sit here, you want to. You better get up. You better tell her to slow down. Now you're not somebody in that car sleeping hard. I wake up and say, y'all just got out. She gonna perish. This is no lie. This just the other week. I said, why are you coming up on this car this fast? She said, I'm slowing down. I just didn't match the brakes. No, that pedal on the left, that's the brake. You got to mash it, stick, put your foot on it, then stretch your leg out. Listen to me. There are some people you can't hang around. Success may make you lonely. You sure you want to be successful, or do you want a lot of friends? Come on, let me read the scripture, then I'm out of here. This people draw nigh unto me with their lips. These people draw nigh me with their mouth and honor me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. We read last week that you can gain the whole world and lose your soul. Now we know that people will say the right things, and yet they be far from God. What do you mean by they can honor me with their mouth and with their lips? You can be a person that say, you have all the right lingo, all the right words to make somebody think you all in the bag of chips in the kingdom of God. Yet God said, I ain't got nothing to do with it. You cannot let people have stuff and influence you to follow them. You got to see character in people. Some of y'all buy books just off the title. I'll make you rich in 3 days. Give me two copies, case my kids get a cold hold of one of them. I need one for the car, one for my bedroom. You don't buy books because of the title.
Right.
You got to know something about the author.
Right.
That book is no more powerful than the author that wrote it.
Right.
Play the piano in 3 hours. And then somebody get on there doing blong, 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 blong. Blum, blum, blum. Now they telling you how to, because they can't take you nowhere they haven't been.
Right.
Everybody wants something quick. You go out there and you spend $5 on that magazine. Especially if they got a seal where you can't open it. And if they got on the cover, £10 in 3 days. Give me this. Listen, I'm going to take that food back. I'm going to put the chicken back. I need this magazine here. Anything easy, you jump on. Stop thinking everybody that got a look got the character. Everybody that got something to show off, that's somebody I should follow.
Right.
You follow someone that has the character of God, not stuff.
Amen.
Come on now.
Amen.
The world is trying to make us think stuff is the deciding factor on whether we should follow people. Stuff is not. There's a spiritual DNA inside of all of us that we get from our parents. Listen to me. I'm going to drop this point. You can take it any kind of way you want. It is proven that your child, you can be separated from your child at birth. 10 years up the road, you guys will have some of the similar things in certain things in life. And you never taught it to them. Liking the same type of foods. Liking the same hairstyle. Doing different things. You know, some children watch their parents and do what their parents do. Some children don't even got to watch.
True.
They mama stand like this, they stand like this. They mama always twisting up, they twisting it. It's just things that fall. Let me tell you something. There are some DNA traits you got to cut off. Now I'm going to say a few things. You're going to get it. If everybody in your family broke, there's some DNA things you got to cut off. You say, well, I'm not broke. You need to cut it off. It's not because you got more than them that you don't need to cut them off.
Right.
You need to cut them off because they can't elevate you.
Right.
They will hinder you.
Right.
Long as you got a certain group of people that promote you all right where you are, you'll never go any further.
Right. Right.
It's all right you got a better car than me. But the problem is, are you reaching the full potential? You know, part of Michael Jordan getting so many votes of being the GOAT is because no matter who was on the court, you wasn't going to embarrass Michael Jordan. No, follow him. If he played you today and you showed off, watch when you see him again on the court. He would come up to whatever level he had to win. Now you say, I'm not here to debate, all right? Whether who, what, where, and who this, that, or another. What I'm simply saying is, how can you keep losing by the same thing over and over again?
Mm.
Tax returns come, tax returns go, and you never elevate it.
Come on now.
My wife was asking me, did we get our stimulus check? Did we get our stimulus check? And we got it back the 1st of January. I never even knew it was in the account because it goes into an account we don't touch. Some of y'all, let me tell you something. Stop making foolish decisions when you get your tax return if that's the only money you got coming in
right. Of
large value. Every year you do the same dumb thing. You're going to buy a radio, a phone, a TV. I'm going to get some rims. No. You need to do something different for a different outcome.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
If you're going to grow, you need to hear God, then you need to obey God.
Yeah, yeah.
There's a DNA trait in you to be broke. Just because you got more than me don't mean you ain't broke, because you should be further along.
Right.
Can you imagine if Michael Jordan was only playing somebody like me? And that was the level of his greatness because he could beat me? Mm-hmm. See, just because you beat everybody on the court don't mean you reach your full potential.
Right. Right. Amen.
That's greatness in you.
Amen.
That's another level in you.
Amen.
Buying a house ain't don't make you better than nobody else in your family
right.
when you're supposed to be renting houses. If God gonna elevate you, he gonna do it in a way everybody gonna know God's hand is on your life.
Amen. Amen.
So now, you're not gonna measure yourself by other people.
Right.
I'm just gonna keep hearing and obeying.
Right.
Stuff gonna be added to me.
Yeah.
Stuff gonna be added to me. Listen, I told you I'm done with cars. Like, you know me going after cars and stuff like that. But I trust God.
Amen.
I'm not gonna be surprised if that Rolls Royce pop up.
Come on now.
Now, I already envisioned that it got to be a gate, you understand? I don't need Holden thinking he won't get shot.
Right, right.
You understand? Because he's a deacon at the church trying to steal my car. I wouldn't be surprised if that Lamborghini pulls up. You know, people don't get this Lamborghini one time. The only reason I didn't get it because it wasn't stick shift. You don't get a Lamborghini for automatic.
Right.
You get a Lamborghini, you know what I mean? They had the thing, you had the clip, right? So we were slowing. Boy, I was so glad we didn't get that Lamborghini because it wasn't too many months later. We hit rock bottom. Y'all ought to have that Lamborghini in somebody's garage. To things pick back up, I ain't lying. I wouldn't be surprised if one show up. What am I saying? I can care less of what kind of car I drive. But God cares about the car I drive.
Yes.
I go after the things of God. And things of the world come after me.
Come on
now.
You ain't got to worry about a good life when you're hearing and obeying God.
Amen.
You ain't got to worry about where you're going to live when you're hearing and obeying God.
Amen.
Nothing can stop you when God is on your side.
Amen.
It's never too late for you to reach greatness. Now, some of us got to shift lanes. What do you mean? The lane God had you in to make your success done expire. No, it ain't done expire. Listen to me. It don't make sense for Holden to be talking about he going to try out at the Eagles. Season gone. Season gone. Stay with the cookies in the machine. Because then you ain't equipped for that. He ain't never even been on a team. He don't know what it's like to get hit with a helmet and pads. You can't be talking about something. I'm NFL material. And you've been playing two-hand touch all your life. Child, when them boys hit you, I'm telling you, ooh, Jesus. Now them boys been trying to knock you, like you the ball, knock you into the... No, it's that season gone. It don't make no sense. You guys shouldn't try to beat no boxer or nothing. He don't even need to be hitting the punching bag too many times. Then you hear something crack, and now your nine's in a cast. No, that's some seasons ago.
Amen.
Now y'all laughing at the men, but you ain't gonna be no Dallas cheerleader yourself.
Right.
Some of y'all, you go up in the air if you want to. Whoops, my bad. Yeah, you open your eyes, you see all that white and machines. No, it's too, that season gone. My wife gave me talking about some, she gonna be some cheerleader. She jump up and down two or three times, and knee gonna swell. No, sit down. You think I'm gonna go a different lane now. You mad at school, stay with that. Be in the food industry. Some of us gotta switch because we done messed up. We done messed up. Don't try to force what is not pop. If Andrew Holyfield was making confession all the time, I'm gonna be heavyweight champion again. No, you're not. You can barely talk now. That means your brain is not functioning right. Well, that boy really bold. He done went to church. Somebody told him he gonna be another. They lying to you. Whenever, if you're talking like this now, I am going to the store and I'm going to buy me some ice cream. Today, and now after your boxing career, and you want to come back, and you, I'm going to the store. No. You done took too many punches to the head. No, I'm telling you, don't try to make anything work. It's not going to. Forget about the modeling industry. Just listen, you ain't gonna hurt my feelings. No, I'm trying to save you some money before you pay for all them photo shoots.
Right, that's true.
Hang it up. It's done, it's over with. No, there's enough. Stop it. Work what you can work. If you
been messed up this path, then if God put you on a different one, make the transition smooth.
Amen.
I'm going to be a rapper. Rap? What? What are you talking about? Gifts?
Right.
You talking about working at Macy's, right?
Yeah.
No, come on now. It don't make no sense for you guys to be up there talking about stuff. All the ladies. You know you want. Come on off the stage.
You got that right, buddy.
Come off the stage. You need to open a plumbing store. No, listen to me, because I want you to be a success. But you just can't go off what some of these preachers are telling you. Just go out and confess it. Claim it, name it, and claim it. You're going to be naming all your life and still be in the same spot.
Amen, amen, amen.
Some things is just over. But God cannot be submitted to your plan, your vision, to make you a success. Let him be God. Father, thank you for this day. Thank you for your people that have come to have living faith, that you can use them and they will grow. I pray that every person under the sound of my voice will not remain on the level that they are, but that they would grow, that they would excel, that not only for themselves, but they would be a blessing to others. Have your way in their life, that they'll be free to love you and build your character in their life. Holy Spirit, you are our helper. Any area of our life that we're walking in laziness, we're slowful, show us ourselves that our life will be greater.
Yes.
And our children's lives will be greater.
Yes.
We'll give you the praise and the glory.
Yes.
In Jesus' name, amen and amen.